Eudaimonia welcomes you. This is Humaira, and today we are going to understand the difference between PCOS and PCOD. So let's get started. It is observed that people confuse between PCOS and PCOD. They interchange the terms. Yes, there are common things between the two terms, but their functionalities, their symptoms vary significantly. So let us understand the mechanism behind this. Apart from the cyst formation, ovaries start secreting androgen. Like I have mentioned, androgen is a male steroid hormone, which even in normal conditions, ovaries will secrete, but in less proportion. Estrogen is a female steroid hormone, which is by default more important for women. But in this case, androgens are secreted far more than estrogen. And that is why we are able to see these unusual changes in female. PCOS is a condition where there are several cysts that are found on both the sides of the ovaries. These cysts are sacs that are filled with fluids. Fluids like immature eggs and other secretions. These cysts are large and various in number. And you are able to detect this in the earlier stage, right when the girl starts getting her periods, right after her first periods also at times. And in such cases, the girl is not able to get her periods regularly. They are very unreliable and irregular. And for some cases, they don't get periods at all. In PCOD, the implications are quite similar. But here, the size of the cyst is smaller and the numbers are less too. Periods are normal in such condition, but it can also be delayed at times. But the difficult part is that you will not be able to identify that you have PCOD until you reach the childbearing age and you're not able to conceive. Some of the symptoms that you need to look out for in PCOS are high risk of obesity, irregular periods or no periods at all, excess facial hair, baldness, there are patches on the elbows or nips, axillary hair, body odor, fatigue, sleep-related problems, depression or anxiety, mood swings and headache. PCOD has similar symptoms, but there are also major differences that are seen. It is rare to be detected at an early age. Periods are irregular rather than none at all. There is heavy bleeding. Since the periods are so irregular, there is a buildup on the uterine wall. So when girls do get periods, they are very heavy. Again, obesity is also at a higher risk. Now, there are some risks that can be of concern in case of PCOS and PCOD. So, first of all, it is infertility that is a major issue, because in PCOD, it causes infertility because of the reduced frequency of ovulation in the body. And in PCOS, the female might not be able to conceive at all, even after making some lifestyle changes. But again, these vary from person to person. They are also prone to be diabetic because both PCOS and PCOD cause insulin resistance in the body that can lead to diabetes. These also have an impact on the heart because it increases the blood pressure in the body that makes the heart problems vulnerable. So there can be possibility of heart diseases. In case of endometrial cancer, it can happen because of the delayed ovulation. And the body will experience a thickening of the endometrium, which is the inner lining of the uterus. So this increases the odds of getting endometrial cancer, which is lower in PCOD but higher in PCOS. In case of depression, because of the hormonal imbalance, it can cause depression, mood swings, anxiety and changed behavior. So we know that PCOS and PCOD are not the same, but their dietary changes can be similar. We know that the risk of obesity is high in both cases. There is insulin resistance seen in both the conditions, and also hypertension is observed. So when you focus on weight management, you will be able to slowly cater all the other issues as well. Weight management will help in lowering testosterone levels, LH levels and insulin as well. It will help in decreasing insulin resistance, and that will help in managing diabetes. When you are into exercise, when you're eating healthy, you will automatically be able to lower your blood pressure and cholesterol levels. So we see that once we follow a healthy lifestyle, once our eating habits are good, we will be able to see positive change in our body. your energy levels will improve, your metabolism will improve, you will feel more active. So the episodes of headache, anxiety and fatigue will be no more. And you also need to identify the unhealthy habits that you have. For example, if you are into smoking, you need to realize that tobacco has an impact on the androgen levels. So once you cease smoking, the androgen levels will also reduce. You should also know that there are various drugs that are given to treat insulin resistance, to make your periods regular and also increase chances of ovulation. But obviously these drugs should be prescribed by a gynec and you should not take it on your own. The dietary guidelines for PCOS and PCOD are quite similar. In case of carbs, you have to include high fiber carbs in your diet. Avoid refined and processed carbohydrates. In case of protein, have lean protein. Like chicken, fish, you can have eggs as well. Avoid red meat, organ meat and processed meat because these have high fat levels and cholesterol levels will rise. In case of fats, include fat omega-3 fatty acid foods like nuts and fish and there's avocado, etc. Include a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables to get all your minerals and vitamins. Keep enough gap between your meals, but do not starve, do not skip any meal. Break it into small meals, have 5 to 6 meals in a day. You should also keep drinking water, keep yourself energized, do not sit in one place for long. Keep yourself active, keep moving, indulge into physical activities. It will be difficult at initial stage because of your weight maybe, but once you start working out, once you start keeping yourself physically active, your body is going to adapt to that and you will be able to feel more energized, and that is going to have an impact on your metabolism as well. In case of beverages, you can have green tea. Please avoid aerated drinks or any drink that has a lot of sugar in it. Sugar should not be more than 2 teaspoons per day. Keep that very minimal. Same way, your salt has to be reduced. Salt consumption should be reduced because your high salt intake can cause water retention, and as it is, there is hormonal imbalance in the body, so it can further aggravate the problem. And oil consumption also should be reduced, not more than 2 to 3 teaspoons per day. And your selection of choice should also be considered. Have olive oil instead of vegetable oil or ghee. Olive oil is a healthier version. And also make sure that you are having enough water, getting enough sleep. With this, we come to an end to today's video. I hope this video is helpful and it is able to make you understand the difference between PCOS and PCOD. I hope we don't interchange these terms anymore. Do share it with people who have this condition or with those who find it difficult to understand the concept. I hope you will be able to follow the dietary guidelines that are given, and if there is any confusion, you can put your message below and we can help you. Do like, share and subscribe to our channel, and we will see you all next time with another topic. Until then, love, invest, find yourself and enjoy.